24 candidates, including President Tshisekedi, are competing for the position. Congress laws limit presidents to only 2 terms. Notable contenders include Nobel Prize-winning gynecologist Denis Mukwege, running for the first time, and Martin Fayulu, who contested the 2018 election results in court after coming second to Tshisekedi. The Independent National Electoral Commission in the DRC announced in November 2022 that the presidential and parliamentary elections would be held on December 20, 2023, with a budget exceeding $600 million, of which more than $450 million had already been allocated at the time of the announcement. In a press briefing at Bunagana, Bertrand Bisimwa, the M23 leader, criticized the upcoming poll, arguing that organizing an election while ignoring areas still under occupation is not right.
In terms of choosing the role given by the East African community, the international community of the dialogue, to solve this problem first. If we heard what you said recently, if Goma been taken by the M23, there would be no election.
Meanwhile, representatives from the 4 DR Congo's 5 main opposition parties held talks in South Africa this week to form a coalition ahead of the elections next month. The meetings were coordinated by the In Transformation Initiative, a non-government group, and the Kofi Annan Foundation. Electoral challenges are not uncommon in the DRC, with the last presidential poll marking its initial democratic transition being delayed by 2 years until finally taking place in December 2018. In that election, President Felix Tshisekedi succeeded his long-standing predecessor, Joseph Kabila. Since March 2022, over 520,000 people have been displaced due to the M23 movement's insurgencies in the North Kivu. Report by Job Namanya in Bunagana, DRC, for the news.